about God does not change your relationship with Him. When you put the word to work, when you put the word of God to work, eventually your circumstances will change, are subject to change. Put to work the word of God. The cases every day in the synagogue here, like last week when I was moving around, if not the gift of prophetic prophecy, meeting some people, they will come here and say, "I have fever." By the time I'm praying, I realize that this is HIV 1 and 2, but it is fever. Until they get to the point of death before they say, "Jesus is Lord, is my healer." Faith is not imitation, which is common among us. Faith is not imitation. It cannot be imitated. It must arise in each person's heart based on the word of God. It must arise in each person's heart based on the word of God. It cannot be imitated. But today, what has happened? You see, everybody did him. Sometimes God deals with people in different way. God will not meet you because you imitate someone else, what someone else did. This is why it's a bit dangerous when you pick a textbook and you read how to pray. The Holy Spirit helps us in our prayer. When you take a textbook and begin to read how to pray, pray for deliverance, pray for this, pray for that, no. God will not meet you because you imitate what someone else did. Tell your neighbor, God will not meet you because you imitate what someone else did. That is, someone else pray. In Jesus' name, after watching the way the person pray, you to get there and say, in Jesus' name. Remember, this one is being inspired to do so. You are not inspired to do so. You are only copy, you are only imitate. Some of you will pick a textbook and begin to read 7 points of way to pray. You want to fast for 3 days because you read this somewhere to do so. The person is being inspired to do so, not you. God will not meet you because you imitate what someone else did. God will meet you when you obey what he told you to do by the Spirit, based on his will. When you take action in obedience to God, you prosper. When you take action in obedience to who? You get it. You prosper. God will not meet you because you imitate what someone else did, like prayer, like fasting. He says somebody has to fast. It's a traditional way. This song to sing. This how to sing it out. This how to sing it in. This is that. This is what we are doing. This is what they ask us to do. This is a lot. God will meet you when you obey what himself told you to do. And he can only say it by his Spirit, based on his will. That is taking action in obedience to God. Today, we stop here. We continue next. Faith is not an issue of ordering God around. You know, today, our prayer is to instruct God. We always instruct God. I need this. In the name of Jesus, give me. You don't mind whether it's his way to give you. You don't even bother to know God's way before you ask. And if you ask according to his way, he gives. Faith is not an issue of ordering God around. So we pray, we instruct God what to do, what to give us. And when that is not given us, we feel bad. It affects our faith. Who knows what will have happened to you if your prayer for better life had been answered? A better life to buy the best car. A better life to build a beautiful house. A better life to become a governor, a minister, a senator. Who knows what will have happened if that your answer has answered to that effect? Who knows what will have happened? So we continue, because this is almost 15 minutes, I say 10 minutes. We continue next week, that we are talking about those things that are not biblical faith, and we practice, we say it's faith. Many things you do, like many testimony today, people came out to say, yes, I minister my money water 4 times. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. You quickly write it down. Why writing it down? When you get your own. You now say, oh, that man minister 3 times. Jesus, Jesus. You now blow your own too. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Nothing happened. But the man that is talking may be inspired by the Holy Spirit to do so. But you are not inspired. You are only imitate this man. You are imitator. Like many of us has book, we read prayer for deliverance. Turn this way, Jesus, Jesus. Another side, Jesus, Jesus. Another side, Jesus, Jesus. It gets frustrated when you do that and the prayer is not answered. But you are imitating. The man, somebody wrote it, the person is being inspired to do so, but not you. You will not meet Jesus because you imitate what someone else did. What someone else did is what you are reading. Unless you receive from God yourself, you will meet God. When you obey what God told you, that is instruction. So may God bless his word. So because I just want to, there are many things we need to do today. I think there's one testimony out of 10 that remain. Let us listen to this. We can move forward, okay? I learned that there's a gentleman, okay? Place at the table. We only have one place because of time. Yes. There's a brother there too. You have. There's a brother there too. You have a new woman. Your love woman, very kind woman you love, but mistakenly you find yourself getting married to somebody outside. And you have rented a secret place, bedroom, flat, somewhere. And you are now beginning to manage your time. Sometimes you sleep here, another time there. So we are just telling you, this coming year, you cannot continue it. It will be very dangerous for you. So come out for your deliverance. The brother I'm talking about, please come out.
In confirmation of the prophecy, a man comes out of the congregation and walks towards Prophet TB Joshua.
Are you not too young?
Yes, man of God. I'm confused.
You're confused?
Yes, man of God.
You're confused?
Yes, man of God.
But this one is never confused. If you're confused, this one will never confuse. If you confuse, can that place confuse? I can hear you. It's him that confused, but that place is a different place. Look, next year, what you are doing secretly now, if you try it next year, you will die. So because the woman you put in that place, hey, they are tracing you. They will get you. Very early morning, they'll just find that they have killed you somewhere. So by the time
you go to the other world, you know you are not this.
So it's a young man.
You are very young, so there's no
Well, you I think this happened last Sunday. Last Sunday, this young man was in this crowd, and the Spirit of God called on him. And this coming new year, there's a danger. This is what you are doing. Could be very, very dangerous. You have wife, you live with your wife, but you have another person somewhere, which you kept there having a child for you. But this new, your wife does not know. But I'm seeing danger coming. But you're going there by next year, January, I see a setup that will be danger. So this is why we are here. These are the issues you will never ask man of God to pray for you. You will leave the important issue, you will be telling man of God a different thing. This is why we are here. Anything that could be danger, could be dangerous for you next coming year. You want Jesus to bring it and separate you from them. Huh? Okay, this is why we are here. So I think the gentleman is here. I say it should bring the wife at home, and the wife at home is hearing it for the first time. And the one in the outside, I want to meet the person too. I want to be brother, father, and you need deliverance, we deliver. You can get his own husband, and so that this will not lead to death. So we are alive, that is why all this is happening. Okay, we talk of. So thank you. Let's hear from my brother. Thank you.
My name is Mr. Amitepe Emmanuel. I am from Togo. The woman beside me is my wife, which I wedded with. During the prophetic service on Saturday, the man of God prophesied that there is a young man there. There's a young man there. You are married, but he secretly rented the house for another woman outside. Immediately I hear this thing, I find it difficult to come out. I was waiting other someone else will come out. Suddenly, just like the fist vibrated machine inside me. My body, I cannot control it again. Everywhere was vibrating, seriously.
You listen to that? He said when I was saying it, he was looking for someone to come out. But before he finished looking around the church, he looked this side church, but before he looked back, something hit his heart. You know, Jesus loves you. He has a way of taking you. It's your creator. He said he could not breathe again. He has to quickly come out. Because, take it back again. Mm-hmm. You say, when I said it, you look around.
I look around. I can't see anyone to come out. The time my body starts vibrating, it happened that I start hearing, pack your teeth around, pack your teeth around. Then I don't know the time I find myself in front of the altar. Everything man of God said is completely true, 100% true. Really, I rented her for a woman which have a son for me. A woman was introduced to me by a friend who supplied sand to us in their site. I already have 6 children. So I was happy then. As time goes on, one day, she discussed with me that as I'm helping her, she wants to have a child for me, who should be a point of contact between both of us, even though when I left the country. So I told her, when we have this canteen, it can cause any problem to me. I'm a foreigner in the country. She said that she knows how to control the issue. Finally, I have started to have an affair with her. Then she now got pregnancy and have the child for me. My wife don't know anything which I'm saying now. This is her first time hearing all those things.
So this is the first time your wife is hearing from you?
Yes, man of God. Because she suspects me.
but I'm not in position to say it to her. She suspects me, asked me several times. My wife asked me several times. We usually have problems with it, but I'm not in position to answer her. That's why I usually pray for man of God to locate me one day and help us for the issue, because I cannot sleep.
Okay.
That woman, you the child, threatening me. Wherever she asks her, or she asks me to meet, come to her house, which I don't want, she will tell me that the other she will carry her child, my child, to come and deposit for me. But the woman is a family friend to us, but I don't want to have anything with a problem between me and my wife. But my wife take her as her sister. She always plant her hair for her. During our wedding time, she was with us, helped us for everything we was doing. My wife thought that she's my sister. Man of God, please help me.
Okay, madam, how are you? So, look, come here. You should thank God she will not be disturbed, because I say you want to fall into conversion. You should thank God, okay? It is time now God wanted to really fortify this marriage. Okay, if there's no marriage, there's no relationship between you and him, I will let you know. Because I see this is a relationship from God. This is marriage from God. No matter the case, like Paul Apostle said, what can separate me from the love of Christ? Whatever happened, see your husband, go there, come and stand there, don't worry, I know you will not mind him, so don't worry, so for you to know that he's not fit. Okay, madam, what, do you know the woman is talking about?
Yes.
That
yes. Yes. I know the woman. The woman is like a sister, like a family friend to me. And during our wedding time, she even organized his own committee of friends, and do his own committee of friends personally, as we are close together. She's like a sister and a family friend to us. She has 6 children already. Then the 7th one, I thought is the woman's son. I don't know that the 7th one is my husband's son. So I'm here, I'm confused. I don't know what to do. Please. And there's some.
Are you hearing for the first time now?
Yes, this is my first time of hearing it.
Okay, it's all right. I think the woman is around.
Yes, man of God.
Okay, sir. Because she's so big. Madam, why are you pantry? It's all right. So I'm the one who called that if you bring the woman. She never knew you would be here. She never knew a patient like this. Maybe she probably think that I want to cement their marriage. Okay, so it's all right. But don't worry, we hold on for now. Where is he? So no, I'm not calling her out, but it's in the church.
Yes, man of God.
Thank you. You should not leave. You should just wait for me. After service, I need to see the family. But simple, the viewers, what I want to see them is simple. Next Sunday, they will come out to give testimony. This is your wife. Okay? Okay, it's all right. So I will meet the other woman and I will talk to her. but one thing is clear, that child is this family's child. We cannot reject it, it's your husband's child. But you will leave your marriage, and the God will forgive your husband and forgive her. But the child is belong to this family, okay? So, but I want to assure you, this marriage is yours. It's yours. God wants to let you know that, look, because if you know this somewhere, that is the end of marriage. You are leaving the marriage, but you have nowhere to go. I will let you know. I will let you see the reason why you cannot leave the marriage. The joy, you begin to enjoy the joy of that marriage from now. Okay, I will be meeting you people. So the woman should wait, and you never knew this is the reason why she was called. But I know he's surprised not to hear this. But for his own good. So please, thank you. The evangelist should go and meet the woman and give her a place to sit. He should not run away. She should not abandon church and run. Okay? So please, will you take, madam, give me your hand. Listen to me. Huh? Okay, sorry. I'll see you. Okay, go and wait for me. I know it doesn't mean anything to many of us here. Because some will just laugh over it and say, ah, it's you. The day God will catch on with you, you will know it means a lot. Something. No problem. The day God will catch up with you. Okay, so thank you. So this is it. We cannot, we cannot bring the woman out. I'll personally see the woman, settle the matter. The woman will go for deliverance today, prayer today, and he'll quit the marriage. And we don't want them to just quit the marriage with disagreement and hatred. So the whole thing will, quit that kind of relationship. The whole thing will be understand both sides. And this man can continue. Okay, I know for many of you, you see it differently. But sometimes God uses, can speak good through bad. He will speak good. That's God for you. So that's it. I know many of you, because of this, you quit the marriage. A lot of marriage quit. There are many people here. Even there's a woman there, you quit your marriage because of what happened. That kind of thing. But today, have you got the right marriage now? So whatever happened, examine them in the light of God. Anything that happened in your marriage, ask God, what does he say about it? God has something to say. In every situation, what does he say? What God has to say. Okay? The answer is not to quit. But the first thing, ask God, is mine. What is your opinion? His suggestion concerning what happened before you think of either quit or stay. When something happens, no matter how big, what does he say? In every situation, God has something to say. Huh? So we don't just quit anything, either marriage or relationship or partnership, business partner or whatever relationship at all. No matter what happens, if God first brings this relationship, it is the same God that will release you and release him. So not crisis, not situation. We should not, because of situation, release ourselves or quit a relationship. No matter the situation. What does he say? Because he's the father of the relationship. If not, you will leave this relationship and meet someone who had quit relationship. You meet someone. man who quit the relationship because of trouble. Two of you, two trouble will meet. If you quit this relationship because of trouble, either embarrassment or betraying or whatever, and you quit, where will you get someone who has not quit a relationship before because of trouble? If you quit this relationship without healing, you will meet someone who quit a relationship without healing. Two of you will meet. The way you quit this relationship is the way you meet the new relationship. Life is, we just need to understand, this is, if there's anything that that brings the challenging, so much trouble we have today, is the relationship we quit every day. Business partner, marriage, friend. The way you quit them, you just quit the relationship, just because the person that is a criminal or bad is bad today, may be a messiah tomorrow if you endure. We have seen where a person you say is it betray you, disappoint you, and you quit and leave him. Now later is the same person in you met in Fusho that stand to be your saviors. You know, say, life is just like that. God owns our future. You don't know what future owns. The bad today can be best tomorrow. And the best today can be the bad tomorrow. The criminal today can be the savior tomorrow. A criminal, a dishonored person can be the trustworthy tomorrow. So life is just like that. Just the same way you change every day. You look at the word of faith we talk about. That your faith may fail, but not utterly. If someone see you down, the person is nobody should make jest of you that because you are down. Tomorrow you may be there again. You may be there again. So you quit relationship because of trouble. Have you found a good relationship now? Have you? Huh? You quit relationship. Think of many relationships you have quit over time, many years. Have you found the good relationship you are looking for? Even marriage. So when situation happen, no matter, ask God. Don't quit. Quit is not the solution. First, this is bad. Woo! Go to God. What next? God is still saying something. Thank you. So I will leave the rest, and I know the last you learn a lot lesson with from what happened now. So how can the man of God now say the woman should still stay? There's a future in that marriage. After so much disappointment. Have a child. And the child, he has been taking care of the child, he never knew his father of the child. Very, very painful. But the man of God said, yes, stay. The future is still there. And not only that, the person concerned that caused that that gave birth to somebody who pretend to be a friend or whatever. Lord God, still invite the person for deliverance so that he can point her to her precious herself again. That is life. We have the power to destroy, but we cannot save. Don't ever reject anyone because it's bad today. Because he may be the savior tomorrow. Tell your friend, don't ever reject anyone because he or she is bad tomorrow. She or he may be the best. Tomorrow is mystery. And when we say mystery, it's what you don't understand will happen. Tomorrow is mystery. Since you don't know what will happen next tomorrow, even the Bible warns us, let's go to the book of Galatians and see what the Bible says about this. He has warned us carefully. The book of Galatians. Galatians 5:6. Take your Bible, Galatians 6. Okay, I read from verse 1. Galatians 6. It says, brothers and sisters, if someone is caught in a sin, in a wrong, you who live by the Spirit, that is, you who live righteous, upright, you that claim you are upright, if you now find someone who is doing wrong, you that upright, hear what the Bible says, restore that person gently. Just like what happened now. You see, I take it again. You see, brothers and sisters, if someone is caught in a sin, in wrong, whether the person commit criminal or murder or whatever the person might have done, you caught the person. Ah! You betray me. You deceive me. You dupe me. Hear what the Bible says. You see? You who live by the Spirit, to live by the Spirit is to live upright, to live faithful. Faithfulness, to be faithful, to be kind, to be sincere, is mean to live by Spirit. Anyone that live by Spirit, live by God, because God is Spirit. You see, you who live by the Spirit should restore that person gently. How can you restore a criminal gently? That is what the Bible says. Should restore the person gently. That is with counsel. See what the Bible says. But watch yourself. Or you also may be tempted. Watch yourself, or also you also may be tempted. You that saying, you smoke, you are a smoker. you're a drunkard, you're a drunkard, you're a smoker, and you are making jest of the person. Tomorrow you may be drunker, you may be smoker. And the person that is smoke today and drinking today may be upright tomorrow. And you that make jest of him become a smoker and drunker. It's only like that. I want you to take note of people around you. Either a pastor or Christian or bishop or whoever that used to. It's a criminal. It's a criminal. Take note. He himself will soon be a criminal tomorrow. You just read that that man become a criminal. And the person they say is a criminal, it's a criminal. Maybe opposite. It's only like that. Because God never gave us power to judge. Even what I was reading to you people about your faith will never fail. He said to even Peter, turn back and help your brothers and restore your brothers. I want to believe that, assume you have been patient enough to endure what has been happening in your former relationship, either your marriage in the past, your friend in the past, your business partner, you have been very patient and endure in the past. I believe in the past, God wanted to prove something, but you could not allow God to prove it, prove them. That was something God wanted to prove in your marriage in the past, but you people could not allow God to prove them. That was something God wanted to prove in your business partner in the past, but you people were not patient enough to endure. Take your time. If you know the rich in society, I'm not saying the average one, the rich, those rich, the most richest people, you know, any one of them, meet them and ask them, can you please, I would be very happy if you can tell me what you have gone through in the past, what you went through. I just want to know. You will hear a lot of stories. A lot of people dupe them, and yet they still work, they still believe working with such a people, because they believe something came to them that, look, the person that duped you today will help you tomorrow. Don't leave the man. Upon millions and billions of dollars they dupe them, they still say, I will continue the business, and the person now becoming the savior next. If you meet every successful marriage couple today, they will tell you many things that will have separated them. They refuse. The news about this and that, even the one they have evidence about, that will have led to divorce, they say no. What they always have in mind is, if I divorce this marriage, I'm not going to marry again. So, well, if I'm not going to marry again, why can't I just leave it? It's only the mind to marry next, the mind to marry again, the mind to marry again, the mind to marry again. When you see a potential of not able to, oh, no, I can't go again. No, you just have to. But I want to assure you, from now, this coming year, from today, treat every relationship with care. Don't ever allow whatever happened during the relationship to lead to quit. Let God Himself release you. You may not want to do as much as you are doing with the person, but don't quit the relationship. If it is money you normally trade with the person to buy you something or whatever, you may stop that, but continue the relationship. Give a phone call. Great. Still visit the person, but that business you normally do is helping you. You can stop it for a while until you are, you know, one get confused and disturbed. You want to know him better. Because when we say this man is not good, you say this man is not good, this man dupe you. Have you find one that is not duping you? This one is not good. Have you find good one? Yeah, I mean, what is the difference between you and the others? Everyone is like that. Everyone. Even you that say somebody is not good, are you good? When we are facing temptation, we know you are good. When we are facing difficulty, we know you are good. When there's no money in the pocket, then we know you are good. And you still remain and maintain your integrity. It's not when the money is in the pocket you say you are good. You are good. Anybody can be good when there's money in the pocket. But when there's no money in the pocket and there's no food on the table, we know you are good if you maintain your integrity. How many of you can? So please, relationship is very, you cannot succeed alone. You need people to succeed. And you cannot go it alone. You need people. You just need people to succeed in life. So relationship is very, 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 very important. So you continue to quit relationship, quit this one, quit this. You know how many people you quit every day? Just insult. You abandon the relationship. You know, I cannot, no, you are too proud. You insult me. Never call me again. That is the end. So I help you, you can't help me, I'm in trouble, you can't give me a call because of that you quit the relationship. No, it's not like that. You know, when a relationship is going to be great tomorrow, Satan seems to be interested. And when Satan is interested in something, he will bring trouble into that relationship, he will make sure unnecessary trouble, it causes confusion. Any relationship you find so disturbed, you know, it's like God is involved. When God is involved, Satan is always want to attack. Anything that will, help you in future, Satan is always interested. He want to attack it. So please, look at this Synagogue Church of Our Nation. You are here today. You know how long you have been planning to come here. You know what you have gone through to be here. Yeah? Some people say if you get to the gate, they will change you. How many? Have they changed you today? Where is the change? They say when you see the man, you see home. Where is the home? Where is the home? I know you have been looking at my back and my front. Yeah? You have been looking at me, but that's why I leave that stage. Because if you see me, look at me at a distance, you may not be able to see me clear. So when you leave here and I'm standing at the altar, you don't get back home and say, no, the man was far, I can't see that thing. Where is the horn? You see, it's just like that. So I want to encourage, this is a new year. We are about to enter the new year. You just have to look. You just need to do new thing. You can't continue repeating yourself. You have been repeating yourself. You have been unfaithfulness and you continue to be unfaithfulness. No, you cannot continue. If this is the direction you have been following, you have to change the direction. I know it's not easy to change. It's only taking so much tax. So please, we cannot continue. Here we find resources, the economic is so troublesome. There's nothing going on. Business is not going on. Nothing is going well. So what are you talking about? So I know this year and this coming year, it will be difficult to deceive you. Very, very difficult to deceive you. It is when you have money in the pocket, people can deceive you. Now you have few. I say when you have money in the pocket and food on the table, plenty one, people can deceive you. You listen to people. But now you have just few in your pocket and a few food on the table. I don't think you will allow anyone to deceive you. So thank you. God bless you. Brother, how are you? So I was, yes. Sister, come on. Why this? You were expecting it. A pastor asked you to fast for 3 days.
Yes.
Speak louder.
Yes, please.
You did not finish the fasting.
Yes, please.
It was the voice of God. Because nobody want to believe anyone now. But we have seen it more than enough. But it's not too late. It's not too late. Okay? So you can do from Monday to six. But today you can start tomorrow. Okay? I'll take it back again. But I want to assure you that the relationship will be, God will bring the relationship back. Because there is, I'm seeing separation. So don't worry. Okay? So I said it. It's all over. Okay? Okay, thank you. Okay, how are you, brother?
Hemos iniciado el tiempo de profecía y ministración por parte del profeta TV Joshua.
Diplomat, there's an issue with your passport. Okay? So I don't want you to, the name, just leave the name. Don't change your name, okay?
Okay.
It has been an issue, you want to change your name? No, that is not the issue of name. It is simple. The spirit of death, they serve death in the family. That they believe in, when someone died, they will still continue to worship the person and all that. And then each time you sleep, you eat in the dream. Sometimes you may not know those who are giving you food.
Yes.
So, but it's only dead people. Okay? And then what you are facing now, you hear voice. Strange voice, what to do, what not to do. Confuse you, you don't know the direction to follow.
That's true.
So I want to see you. So, but there's a journey before you, okay?
Yes.
So this is, I see you travel to UK. Okay?
Thank you, Mother God.
So come on, give me your hand. So, and the pie, coming from the anus, it's a family problem. Okay. Problem of pie, huh? How are you, brother? Where is your wife?
She's at home.
The reason why I'm asking is there's an issue, but you are too young to have this kind of challenges, and it's too early. Okay?
Yes, sir.
It's too early and you are too young. Just put it behind you. What first you need to do, this is the second time you're having this disappointment.
Yes,
okay.
Sir. Yes, sir.
The disappointment, but I think that should not happen again. Get it to the point of breakthrough, you are sent back.
Yes, sir.
Point of entry, they send you back.
Yes, sir.
¿Dónde está tu esposa? ¿Hay un problema? Déjalo atrás. Está, es muy temprano. Seguimos con...
How are you? Please bring the woman back.
Why? Yes, everything! Don't deny everything! Yes, it's right, she's not married.
Family?
Yes! I don't understand why she has a kid, but I'm stopping everything!
Come on, you say what? Come on. I want to see her, please. Go. You have problem with your menstruation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And it has been a battle. Come on, come here.
Problemas con tu menstruación.
So, the issue of land property.
Yes, man of God.
How far? What is wrong? What is going on?
I bought a land for my sister, and I don't know what is going on now. And
because this has caused your sister to be sick. The menstruation.
Yes.
You have six menstruation.
Yes, sir.
Six menstruation. Go and wait for me. You'll see your menstruation.
Thank you.
Go and wait for me. How are you? Come on. I want to see you because you're from your father's side, there is idol.
Yes, sir.
And you know about that. When you are very small, you find yourself following masquerades.
Yes, sir.
I think it's like somebody they have stole. You cannot reason well, you don't even understand what you are doing, you quit job, you quit everything, even your family too, there's a problem.
Yes, sir.
And when you sleep, it's like you find yourself in the meeting.
Yes, sir.
Where you don't understand what's going on.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you gotta wait for me. So where is Esther? Wait for me, come on. How are you, brother?
L'homme de Dieu lui a dit qu'il y a une idole de côté de son père.
Okay, when are you traveling?
Fantastic.
No, you are, when you get back to your country, I'm seeing you traveling again.
On Friday.
Well, it's not Thursday, Friday.
Friday.
That's what I'm saying. I know you travel on Thursday, but when you get back to your country, you are going somewhere on Friday.
Yes.
I want to see you. where there's a case.
Yes.
There's a court case.
Yes.
Huh?
True.
So please, can you write it down? I want to see you. You wait for me.